Corey Faust here again with Caster Concepts. Today I wanted to discuss with everyone a topic of what bearing is in your caster. Good. The first bearing that I'm going to discuss here is the one to my far right. This is what we refer to as a roller bearing. It comes apart into three separate pieces. The first part here is going to be the outer sleeve that has a little cut in it to allow for expanding and contracting the heat that builds up as the caster is rolling. Then on the middle of it, we have what is actually the rollers within the roller bearing itself. And what slides in the middle of that is also another full sleeve, no cut. And that's going to be where your bore or your axle is going to slide through the middle of the wheel of the caster. And when these are all put together, there's going to end up being some grease that goes around in the middle of this to allow less friction in the movement when the wheel's spinning. The next most common bearing that we have here is going to be this little guy that's our precision ball bearing. Not to be confused with a circular round bearing that most people would probably think of when you hear the term ball bearing. Unlike the roller bearing, it's all one piece that's going to go in there. Typically, these are going to be found in your maintenance-free casters where there's no grease fitting to maintain. And the third and final bearing that we have here out of the most common bearings used in Caster Concepts wheels is going to be what we call a taper bearing. It comes apart into two separate pieces. The piece here in my left hand is going to be what we refer to as the cone. It's got little rollers all around the outside of it here, and it comes together in the piece here in my right hand that we refer to as a cup of the taper bearing. And these will also have grease on them, just like the roller bearing, to allow for reducing friction while it's spinning in the wheel. These are the three most common bearings found in the wheels of Caster Concepts, made in the USA.